in the Anoka-Hennepin School District. Our school is represented by one team, the Anoka TV News members. These are their stories.
What's happening, Anoka? I'm Marissa.
And I'm Amin. Today is Monday, January 24th.
We here at TV7 know you are excited for the Morp Spirit Days. Today is Minnesota Monday. Let's see that Minnesota-themed clothing. Tuesday is Dress as Your Favorite Holiday. Just like it sounds, wear your favorite holiday-themed attire. Think St. Patty's Day, Valentine's Day, your favorite cultural holiday, ugly holiday sweaters, 4th of July, and of course, Anoka's favorite, Halloween. No costumes, please. Wednesday is Wild Animal Wednesday. Wear anything with a wild animal on it or any animal print.
The Spirit Week continues Thursday with Country versus Country Club, you know. Anoka Spirit Day with Great Color Wars. Seniors wear your maroon. Juniors wear white. Sophomores wear gray. Freshmen wear black, you know. Let's show our spirit at the Morp Pep Fest next Friday. As always, make sure all spirit wear is school appropriate.
The Powder Buff volleyball game is set for this Wednesday at 7 p.m. The cost to watch is $3. Cheap for the amount of entertainment that you'll get. Please bring exact change. Should be a fun night.
More ticket sales will be extended through lunch tomorrow. Cash sales will be accepted. However, students must see Ms. Curtis in the finance office to get a blue clearance slip to be able to complete a cash purchase. Please see Ms. Pelzo with questions.
Congratulations to this week's Senior Youth Salute recipients, Mason McArdle and Jillian Lee. Stop by the glass cases near the cafeteria to read more about their accomplishments and school involvement.
Anoka girls basketball team will be doing a fundraiser on Tuesday, February 1st at the Chipotle in Riverdale. 33% of all event sales will go to the basketball team. So let's all plan to get up there and have a burrito for the girls basketball. I might not be there, but you all can go, you know?
Speaking of places that Amin will not be, I'm sure you all are going to go to parent-teacher conferences that will be held on January 27th from 2:50 to 7:30 p.m. Parents will have the option of meeting face-to-face, in person, or virtually. Please use the following link to sign up for your conferences, www.myconferencetime.com/AnokaHS. There will be no Lighthouse on Thursday, January 27th due to parent-teacher conferences.
Time for a look at the bland old weather, and for that, let's check in with everyone's favorite weather watcher, Masha.
Thanks, anchors. You ready for this, Anoka? It's still really cold. A wind chill advisory is back again starting tonight with the air temps as low as negative 12 degrees. The cold will stay with us until later in the week with the temps climb back into the 20s. They will feel amazing. That's your weather. I'm Masha. Now back to our anchors.
Excellent.
Thanks, Masha. The Anoka Theater Department and myself are preparing our Competition One Act, the Aeneid, for performance this Saturday in subsection competition. Good luck to our director, Mr. Sullivan, and my fellow cast and crewmates.
The speech team continued its successful return to in-person competition with a top five finish at the Arono Odyssey. Nick Bragg took first in creative expression. Our own Kennedy Dieterman won her second tournament in a row in informative, and newcomer Rita Burek took first in novice poetry. Great job this weekend.
We should also add that Joseph Morphew became the all-time leading scorer in Anoka speech and debate history. The previous record had stood 24 years. We are very busy in the world of sports and activities, and for that, let's check in with our fellow anchor, Kennedy.
Thanks, anchors. This weekend, Anoka gymnastics team hosted the Tornado Tumble in the Fieldhouse. They took second place in a close meet. Top five finishers in varsity were Sydney West, Cecily Fager, Annie Hiley, and Sarah Gatlin. The Tornadoes are hosting two more home meets this season and would love to see you there. This Thursday, they take on Maple Grove at Sandburg at 6:30 p.m. Congratulations to our freshman wrestlers for a strong performance at ninth grade sections, with three advancing on to state. Wyatt Rothram, Michael Chamberlain, and Luke Deschin. Good job, young brawlers. The varsity wrestling team continues their dominant season with a 77-11 win over Maple Grove last Thursday. There are still some big conference meets coming up. That's your look at sports and activities. I'm Kennedy. Now back to our anchors.
Thanks, Kennedy. Remember, if you missed anything, be sure to subscribe to the Anoka TV News channel on YouTube.
Today's lunch is beef and black bean chili.
Before we go, today's fun fact is that it's physically impossible for pigs to look up in the sky.
Thanks again to our roaming field reporter somewhere at the local Anoka farm somewhere for that fun fact. Well, that's the news. Until next time, from Marissa, I'm Amin. Have a great day, Noka. Thumbs down.